Hello students, hope you all are doing great. I'm Achal Chaudhary, working as an assisting professor in management department. Today I'm going to share an online video on principles of management.
So students, in previous lecture we have studied coordination, principles of coordination, organization structure and organization chart. So we will be continuing with Unit 3, and today we will be covering organization manuals, type of organization structure, leadership, need of leadership, functions and qualities of a leader. Organization manuals. An organizational manual provides and supplements additional details to the information supplied by organization chart. The members of organization will find it to be readily available reference defining the scope of authorities and responsibilities of management. So basically it's a small book which contains information regarding like details of various positions, their authorities and responsibilities, what will be the job description, and what are the duties and functions of each position, and organization procedure and methods. All these things are included in the organization manuals so that workflow will be easily and ongoing. Next is your types of organizational structure. There are 5 types of organizational structure. First is your line organization, functional organization, line and staff organization, project management organization, and last is your matrix organization. So students, before continuing this slide, so let me tell you that this question can be asked in short type of questions. Like you can be asked like, what do you understand by line and staff organization? So these type of short answer types can be asked from it. So first is your line organization. Basically in this, authority flows from in a vertical form, like where topmost executive gives command to their subordinate and those subordinate will give command to their lower level, and the hierarchy follows like this only. So here the highest authority or power lies with the topmost executive, and it is reduced through each successive level down the organizational scale, and it is one of the commonly used structure as it is easy to understand and implement. So it is one of the historical method which has been used from past decades. So next is your functional organization. And this is organization structure. A structure is organized on the basis of same type of work or activity. Please note down this word, that same type of work or activities are the basis for this, and its main focus is on specialization of work, and it can be adopted by big organizations only where there are lot of functions, where you can divide the lot of departments, you can divide the work into lot of functions according to the functions. So next is your line and staff organization. Basically it is a combination or add-on for the above two types. In this, line officers are the executive and staff officers are the advisors. In this, duties and responsibilities are clearly defined and those are related to each other. Next is your project management organization. Basically, it focuses on the successful completion of the projects by assigning the project managers to each of the projects. So when an organization has a few number of projects, but the projects have longer duration, a pure project organization is proposed. Each project manager is appointed and he or she is responsible to conduct all the activities associated with that particular project. So the project manager is responsible to the program manager. And last is your matrix organization. As the name defines itself, It's a combination of all other types. In this, people are selected from different departments and different levels of the business, like, but it will be within the business only. This structure can be used in both hierarchy of flat organization. Committee organization. A committee is a group of persons who consciously and deliberately formed to discuss a problem and provide solutions to overcome it. They meet on an organized basis to discuss and deal with the matter placed before it. So basically, in this, a committee is formed by a group of people where they came together to take some decisions and for implementation of such decisions. And also it can be formed to provide suggestions and recommendations. Network organization. Networking means a system of trying to meet and talk to other people who may be useful to one in one's work. So basically, in a networking organization, the critical management decisions are with whom to develop business relations and for what and on what basis. The central organization management is especially involved in strategic decisions of developing new relations. They focuses on the developing new relations and eliminating some old, less useful relations with business partners. So in the central or hub organization of the networking structure, usually there is an absence of horizontal and vertical boundaries. Basically, it don't focuses on horizontal or any kind of vertical boundaries. Free form organization. A free form of organization is purely an autocratic structure. It has no boundaries. It is flexible, adaptive, and is built around special problems to be solved by a group of experts possessing diverse professional skills. These experts have decision-making authority and other powers. Free-form organization, it is highly flexible and dynamic and can be followed in order to suit the unique requirements of each project. So here, role clarity is somehow missing. But in its place, people are greeted with an exciting opportunity to do the things by their own. So it is a boundaryless organization where employees are free to share new ideas. Next topic of the day is leadership. So leadership is the ability to persuade others to seek defined objectives enthusiastically. It is the human factor which binds a group together and motivates it towards goals. So basically, leadership is a process by which an executive can direct, guide, and influence the behavior and work of others towards the accomplishment of specific goals. So basically, leadership is a kind of capacity or an art by which you can influence a group of people towards achievement of their goals by motivating them and by developing some future visions so they can achieve whatever they want to achieve. What is your need of leadership? Like, why do you require leadership in your organization? First is your initiates action. So here, leader is a person who tells his followers that from where they have to start and tell them about the policies and plans which they have to follow to achieve their goals. So like this, he initiates the action of overall organization. Next is motivation. Leader motivates the employees with economic and non-economic rewards and thereby gets the work from his subordinates. Next is your providing guidance. Guidance here means instructing the subordinates the way they have to perform their work efficiently and effectively so that errors can be eliminated, right? So by providing a proper guidance to the employees, you can take the work from those employees and also it will eliminate some kind of errors in the organization. Next is your creating confidence. When a leader clearly explaining his subordinates about their role and giving them guidelines to achieve the goals effectively and appraising their work, so all these will build a confidence among the subordinates. Next is your building morale. Morale here denotes willingness of cooperation of the employees towards their work and getting them into confidence and winning their trust. So a leader can be a morale booster by achieving full cooperation so that they can perform with their best of their abilities. Characteristics of leadership. It is an interpersonal process. Interpersonal process means like manager has to influence or guide someone others. Like he has to guide his workers towards the attainment of goals. Second is leadership defines some mentioned qualities which have to be present in a leader. Like he should be intelligent enough. He should be mature enough to take decisions. His personality should be attractive so that his followers can follow him like this. Next is it is a group process. अब ऐसा तो नहीं है कि आप खुद से ही इंट्रैक्ट कर रहे हो एंड देन आप खुद को ही मोटिवेट कर रहे हो. यू आर मोटिवेटिंग योर सेल्फ फॉर अकम्प्लिशमेंट ऑफ गोल. सो दिस इज नॉट अ लीडरशिप. इट इज अ ग्रुप प्रोसेस वेयर टू और मोर पीपल्स आर देयर एंड दे आर इंट्रैक्टिंग विद ईच अदर. नेक्स्ट इज लीडर इज इन्वॉल्व इन शेपिंग एंड मोल्डिंग द बिहेवियर ऑफ हिज फॉलोअर्स. Next is your leadership is situation bound. It acts according to the situation. Formal and informal leaders. A formal leader is one who is formally appointed or elected to direct and control the activities of their subordinates. So basically, he is a person who is created by the formal structure, enjoys organizational authority and is accountable to those who have elected him in a formal way. So he has to work according to the prescribed rules and regulation. He has to follow a specific pattern. Here, leader has to complete his responsibility. So next is your informal leaders. They are not formally recognized. They drive authority from the people who are under their influence. In any organization, we can always find some person who can command and who are approached to guide, to help, to protect the informal leaders. These are the things that you can say here. No formal relations is mandatory. A leader can guide his follower according to his choice. He is not bounded by some responsibilities. What are the functions of a leader? So first is your setting goals. A leader is expected to set goals and policies to persuade the subordinates to work with confidence. Organizing. The second function of a leader is to assigning roles appropriately according to the individual abilities so that they can keep their best, and also it will help in organizational growth. Next is your initiating action. A leader is a person who is followed by a lot of people, so he should not be dependent upon others for any kind of decisions or judgment. So he should be capable enough to start from his own. Next is your direction and motivation. So it is one of the primary function of a leader to guide and direct his group and motivate people to do their best in the achievement of their goals. Next is your link between management and workers. So a leader is assumed as a link between the management and the workers. He maintains a coordination between the management and workers. So so that there will be no disputes or conflicts that can be arrived. So last topic of the day is qualities of a leader. First is your self-managing. So it's hard to manage others effectively if you can't manage yourself. If you are not capable enough to manage yourself, so in that situation, आपको कौन follow करेगा? They will laugh on you and will not take you seriously. So it is an important quality of a leader. Next is your being an effective communicator. Powerful leaders know when to talk and when to listen. If people don't understand and are not aware of your expectation, then they will fall short. So the more specific and concise, so you should be more specific and concise while communicating. Next is your managing complexity. Leader must be problem solver. He must be a problem solver who can take decisions under any kind of situation, under any situations. So leader should be aware of all kind of complexities and with their solutions. Next is your fostering creativity and innovation. Leader must have the creative and innovative approach for the things. Doing this will foster the innovation that will steer your organization to new destinations in a changing business environment. So, creativity and innovation is the most important quality of a leader. Next is your team building and promoting teamwork. A successful leadership is built on the people around you. Team building is essential to leading a unique group of people with distinct personalities, motivations, and skills. So, that's all for today's lecture. In next video, I'll be continuing Unit 3. So here are the questions which has been asked earlier in your university exams. First question is, what do you understand by organizational structure? Question number 2, what do you understand by leadership? Define the significance of leadership. And your question number 3 is, explain the meaning of formal and informal leaders. Also explain in details qualities of a good leader. So you have to solve these questions. I hope you are clear with today's lecture. And if you have any doubt, do let me know. I'll arrange a doubt session for you. Thank you so much for your time. Stay tuned for more videos.